even the flight here, which took like, not here, but to Rio, which took like 12 hours, was surprisingly okay. The show in Rio was good, and today is probably even better.
So, and you just flew here?
Yeah, we arrived like 1.5 hours ago.
So, you have been busy since your departure from Sonata Arctica. You've been...
Yeah, I kept myself busy.
Yes, Sidonco, Kids Offering, Stratovarius, even you had a little work with Arion.
Yeah, that too.
And now you have the Dark Element. So, how do you pick your projects? Do you have a general routine, or you just see what comes on your path?
Well, basically just flow with the go with the flow. See what comes up, and everything that I've done has come fairly naturally. Like, I was asked first to do some work for Arion, and then I somehow got involved with Stratovarius, writing with them and recording with them. Things just happened, and then Frontiers contacted me about writing first for, I don't know how it's called, Place Vendome, I don't know how it's pronounced, no one knows. And after that they asked me to write and produce an album, which then came The Dark Elements. It just, work comes to me.
That's good, right? So, with The Dark Elements, you were asked to write an album for what was your choice. You said you wanted to write for a woman.
Yeah.
Did you have in mind to start writing when they asked you?
I didn't have any particular vocals in mind. I just told them that I'd like to work with a woman since I have never done that before. So it would be a nice change since I've worked with like a lot of really good male singers, like Paco and Pepitoto and all these guys. I thought it would be a nice change of pace, and I didn't have any specific goal in mind for this project. I just told Frontiers that I want to work with a female singer, and they said like, okay, we'll find you one. And it took like a week, and they got back to me like, how do you feel about Anette Olsson? And I said, sure, of course. Great idea. I would not have thought it myself, but when I started thinking about it, I really like her voice. It's very like pop voice. It came very naturally again.
Right. And does the vocalist play a big part in the way you write beyond vocal range?
Yeah, somewhat. Like, of course, the vocal range is the important part, but that's only a matter of like finding the right key and stuff like that. But of course, you have to think about who is singing them, especially lyric-wise. Some people can say stuff that other people can't say. It's not credible. And of course, and writing stuff for a female singer was different, since I had to think about like storytelling, that how can I put the same things in a different perspective? And I think it worked. And of course, with Arion, it was the first time I wrote for them. You had to think about, like, they were so young. The guys were like 18. So you have to write something that an 18-year-old guy can sing and still sound believable. Since they, at that point, you don't have that much life experience. So you can't really get too deep and dive to the deep end. You have to write something that is credible for them. Every time I write for a vocalist, I think about, like, what can they say and still sound believable.
Have you seen YouTube comments on Dark Element videos?
No, I never look at those.
Some people, actually a lot of people said the sound really fits her. They liked the combination of the songs you wrote for them, but I think...
I agree, it turned out really good. Of course, at first it was for me a bit getting used to her style of singing, but when I sent her the first song and she sang it, like a demo version of it, and sent it to me, and yes, now I know what we're doing and what suits her, and after that it's pretty easy actually.
Do you plan to, or do you like to do an entire tour with Dark Elements?
I would like to, and we had discussions about a few options, but at this point I don't see it very possible that we would do a full tour. We are going to do like a few festivals now during the summer, and we are talking about some other shows as well. But of course it's a matter of timing, and people are kind of busy. Well, I've been kind of busy lately. But hopefully at some point we could do at least a short tour.
There is some requests here in South America. You have
this tour is just starting, so I can't really say anything about that yet, and I have not had any discussions about South America yet, but of course I would love to come here with Annette as well, since, well, I can't say that I always loved it here, since I've only been here once, but the one time was really cool, and now, judging from yesterday and probably from today, it's gonna be awesome again. So I would really like to, and if there are any promoters who are willing to bring us over and we have the time, why not?
Let's hope.
Fingers crossed.
Right. Many people focus on your lyrics in general. Are lyrics personal for you, or more of a necessity?
Well, of course they're always a necessity, and that's the part where I struggle most with my writing. Like, when I have to start writing the actual lyrics, I always, when I write a song, I do like demo lyrics, so I can sing something. And usually I end up using a line or two from that. But yeah, most of them are on some level personal. I'm not a great storyteller. I can't come up with an awesome story that would have like no basis in reality. I don't think any of the songs are actually like autobiographical, but in every song there's some parts that are personal to me, and I don't think most people can pick what those parts are, but that's my secret.
True. They don't need to know.
No, and I don't like to explain my lyrics, since every person makes their own evaluation of the lyrics and what it means to them, and I don't want to ruin that.
Yeah, always with someone. Somehow.
If it fits them, I don't want to go saying like, no, I was writing about something totally different, you're totally wrong.
And Botkin's Offering, you said that if there would be a third album, it would be 2019. You said that you are busy right now, but do you see it happening next year, maybe later?
I see it happening, but probably won't be 2019. Like, I've had discussions about this with labels, and I've even started writing, but with my schedule at the moment, it's impossible to get it done by 2019. But hopefully it comes 2020. Maybe.
Maybe.
But I need time to write it, and of course, Timo has Stratovarius, and Ines has Stratovarius as well, so it's kind of, you have to manage the timetable pretty well.
I asked you that before, if you ever plan to sing again, you said no. Do you still don't plan to sing?
I don't really feel much need to sing lead. I'm not very comfortable with it, since I know that I'm not good at it. I can do it a little, but when you work with guys like Anette and Matti Pelto and Kakko and Antti Raivo, these guys who are like amazing, makes me feel like this small with my singing. I like singing backing vocals and harmonies. Like, tonight there's gonna be shitloads of them in the acoustic shows, and there it works. But I don't see myself as a lead vocalist ever.
Do you had any reasons to come to South America as a duo and artist?
Yeah, we wanted to do it. Like, it started as a joke. Me and Timo were just having some beers over in Finland and thinking that it would be kind of cool to do like a duo tour in South America. And we joked around about it like 2-3 years, I think. And then, well, then Eric De Haas got involved, and here we are. It actually happened.
People here have been waiting for both of you here for a real long time. Timo came with Stratovarius 2 years ago.
Yeah, I think. Kind of risk coming here in the first place with Timo, but then when Eric got involved, we knew him, that he's a great guy and he's gonna make it good. Well, if some promoter asks us and we can make the timetables fit, I don't see no problem in it. Maybe not as long tour as me and Timo are doing now. But maybe 6 to 10 shows would be okay. And me and Timo are now doing 27.
Yeah, that's 6 weeks. Short period of time.
Yeah, 6 weeks. It's a long tour.
I have a few personal questions now. Do you have any favorite song of your own? One that you wrote or called a special place? Or a music that inspired you?
That is a difficult question. Of course, I have some of my own songs that I really like. From Cain Suffering, I really like Oceans of Regret. And I like Ante Mortem and My Heart Beats for No One. There are some good ones. From the Dark Element, I like Dead to Me and My Sweet Mystery. And what else have I written? I
can't remember. Well, so is there a song you look forward to performing on this tour?
On this tour? Yes.
You're not gonna tell me?
I'm not gonna tell it, since I'm not gonna reveal our set list.
If you could plan a tour without any restriction of time and money, which places would you love to go?
Everywhere. If there was no restrictions, then everywhere, of course.
Not a particular...
Well, I always like it here in South America. And I always like going to Japan, for instance. And then, of course, it would be fun to go to some really obscure place like New Zealand or something. Like, I was lucky enough to go to Australia with Insomnium last year.
That's unusual.
Yeah, I don't think too many bands go there. So. Or Alaska.
Well,
Antarctic. Metallica
think
that.
Do you have an idea where you want to be in 10 years?
Probably pretty much where I am. Maybe I could be a bit more successful still. I think I've reached the limit yet. Basically, I want to keep doing what I do now. I feel I've been very lucky. Last 5 years or so. I get to do a lot of work with different people and I get to tour with different projects. It doesn't really get much better.
There has been a talk of a second part of to this tour, the acoustic tour, in 2019. Do you have any plans
for
that?
Yeah, there has apparently been talk and I read about it from the internet. I haven't been talking with anyone. But apparently, Eric has this idea of bringing us back 2019 in this fall. And if the schedules fit and this tour goes well, I don't see no problem in it. Like for instance, now we only do 3 shows in Brazil. And Eric said that he could have booked like a 4. Yeah. And Eric said that he could have booked like a lot more. But we had to tell him like, no more, it's 6 weeks already. Like, we can't do 2 months.
Yeah, Brazil is a pretty huge country and you do have fans up in the north and they are pretty upset that you're not going there. Maybe
it's not our fault. We don't book the shows. Other people do that. We go where we're told to.
You have been playing music for quite some time. Do you ever picture yourself doing something else?
Well, yeah, I have never done really anything else professionally. I started quite young and then when I was like 19 the first Sonata album came out, so I didn't really have any chance of doing anything real job. I've been doing this ever since. Of course, every once in a while when you get like tour depression or something, you start thinking like, does this make any sense and should I get some real profession? But the thing is that kind of shitty at everything else.
Well, you got lucky, like
yeah,
you say.
I get lucky and I think about it occasionally, but then when you start to think about it, what would be better than this? And the answer is nothing.
If you don't write or play music, what do you enjoy?
Well, I enjoy like Finland if it's like spring,
like
summer.
Here.
Yes, I like that, but I also, when I'm back home, I go running or I go to the gym, or if I want to just relax, I play PlayStation or something. But it's kind of rare since it seems like I'm working all the time with something.
You're always busy.
Yes, and I don't really mind. I like being busy.
Do you have any preparations before the show?
It depends on what show it is. Like with Timo, it's kind of easy. Just change your stage clothes, have one beer and warm up a bit. And for instance with Insomnium you have to warm up a bit more since it's more technical stuff that you have to play. But other than that it's pretty similar. It's basically it's just waiting around until it starts. It's kind of boring actually.
Yeah, it's a long wait.
Yeah, in this profession you do shitloads of waiting. You wait at the airport, you wait at the venue, you wait at the hotel. Like most of this stuff is waiting for something. Yes, very patient. I have to say that I really am not. I get kind of anxious easily.
You have played a few times with Kings of Friendly. How was that experience? Do you have any difficulties playing the songs for the first time live?
It worked out better than I thought. Like when we started rehearsing and I had to start to learn to play the part myself, I was like, shit, this is difficult stuff. Like I don't know if we can pull this off, but kind of lucky and I have great musicians with me. When we rehearsed the first time I was like, okay, it actually works, like no worries, the guys know what they're doing. So it was actually really fun to play live. And of course it was a funny story to tell to people, like the first show we ever did was in Tokyo. Like, who the hell goes there to play their first show?
You also have huge comebacks there.
It seems like it, yeah. The show sold really good, and then the Loud Bark Festival, it was a huge festival, we had an amazing crowd there.
For this year, you don't have much for Kings of Friends since Timo's visit.
No, I don't think we do anything with Kings of Friends this year since Stratovarius is starting to record the new album soon. And well, I've been touring with Insomnium, and I'm gonna take some time off now. During the summer I do that two Dark Element shows that we have, and then maybe one or two shows with Timo in Finland, but that's it. Like I'm gonna take some time off, so it's just be kind of burning myself out.
Need some rest.
Yes.
So these were all the questions I had to ask you. Thank you again for
no,
your time.
My pleasure.
We are glad that you're here and we wish you good luck tonight and
we will need it
for the rest of this tour.
Thank you, everybody.